Okay, students, so thank you very much for joining. So students, today I will start with the question writing, and let's observe where you went wrong and what improvements you could have made. So students, if you can hear my voice and if the screen is also visible, can you please put Y in the chat box, students? If the screen is visible, thank you very much. Thank you very much. So first thing I need to say, Aju, are you there?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Yes, now Aju, like I just observed your answer, like the quality of your answer was really strong. So Aju, the first thing I wanted to say is now a good practice. Now, I think only Aju has written in the answer about the decentralization. Correct, Aju, because if you observe, I think you wrote the answer of decentralization. That means our airports, what we own, are completely decentralized. Agree, no, students? Every airport has its own management. So students, now that process is very, very important, that thought process, because here you are thinking specifically like you are a finance manager in our field, in the group actually. So if you observe here, one airport they have mentioned, but you need to observe what they are stating as well. And Vamsi, you have done a wonderful job on being very specific to what they require. So Jaydeep, are you there? Jaydeep?
Yes.
Jaydeep, by any chance, were you able to read the answers of Aju and Vamsi?
Yes, sir.
Do you observe that specification was the issue? Other than that, everything was good.
Yes, sir.
Shelby, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Shelby, do you observe what I was saying? Were you able to observe their answers, and did you see there was a connectivity issue there, like a practical one? Do you observe that, Shelby?
Yes, sir. Sir, I couldn't understand the second part of the question. However, okay. first part of the question, I understood where I went wrong.
Okay, okay. So students, now if you observe, strategic case study is very much practical. And again, students, you can pass this paper even without the theory knowledge. So you may be aware about A-STAR program, where only students needs to do this SCS and complete it. So the main reason here is you should be thinking in a matured point of view. So students, first of all, let's come here. So Marcus Jacola. So Vamsi, who is Marcus Jacola? Shelby, who is Marcus Jacola?
CEO of Airfield.
CEO of Airfield. So do you need to explain to CEO about our own company?
No, sir.
Then why did you write that?
Right, sir.
Now let's assume, when you are talking to Ratan Tata, will you say Ratan Tata is the owner of Tata Industry? No need to say that, because he already knows about his own company. So students, be very, very be specific to the requirement. Okay. Today I saw an online news that is circulating at Norland. Okay. Online news circulating at Norland, stating that the freight handling system has been hacked. Okay. The freight handling system. So students, be very careful, freight. So students, if you observe in our airline sector, how many types of revenue we have? One is revenue from the freight. Other one is what? Shelby?
So the passengers.
Passengers. So one problem is many of you all have connected this to the passengers, but actually this is not passengers, it's freight handling. It may take around 5 days to repair the system issues. So 5 days is the time period. The problem was detected by Norland Customs. Okay, they have observed that. When they came for inspection, they observed the system is not detecting any metals. Okay, so the customs has identified that. The customs spokesman has stated, we had a suspicion. Since the metal content in Norland is increasing, we just came here for a spot check. Now, students, my question here, when the customs spokesman has stated like this, what is the risk here you are facing, students? What is the risk you are facing here?
This is a reputation risk.
Excellent. Reputation risk. So students, now your mindset should be in that perspective. Because students, I never saw anyone using the term reputation risk connected to this one. Because when an external government servant says something about your company, that will definitely cause a reputation risk. So just keep in mind. Marcus further wanted that all executive directors should take the responsibility of the above risk and develop a strong risk management system updating the risk register. Please be kind enough to respond on the following. Firstly, look at the term here, identify and explain, okay, interest of key stakeholders for the above situation. For the above situation, interest of key stakeholders for the above situation. Now here, no need to memorize Mandelow matrix, students, and you need not write, but even if you don't know Mandelow matrix, still you could have got the full marks, provided that you apply these concepts in detail. Okay. So students, what I will do is, this is one technique I always say. Okay, so I will write down here, interest, I'll take the heading, interest of key stakeholders. I take the heading from the question itself, interest of key stakeholders for the system issue. Interest of key stakeholders for the system issue. So what I will do is I will just take out the heading. And how many percentage students is this? This is coming to how many percentage students? 60%. That is clear, no? And then they are specifically stating, explain, second one, they are specifically coming to another area, that is evaluate the CEO's proposal on the executive directors should collectively own and manage the risk. So I'll write down here, evaluation of collective risk management by the board. Okay, so students, now again, you need not have a perfect heading, but still you need to know where you are concentrating on. So students, this is 40%. So now remember how this needs to be done. And we do not have any other reference material. So this is like a brain thinking question. Information is less, you need to think a lot. So students, the interest of key stakeholders for the issue. So one I can say is Norland Customs. What do you think, students? Yes or no? Norland Customs is one key stakeholder that is there in the question itself. So it is very essential. And then students, I can say shareholders. What do you think, students? Because if you observe, the company is a listed organization. And the beta factor, I think no one has written. I never saw anyone writing beta factor in the answer. So Vamsi, what is the current beta factor of our stocks?
1.25.
So students, whenever you see the shareholders, please don't forget the beta, students, because it's very, very important indicator for their cost of equity. So Norland Customs, shareholders, and then students, I can say freight suppliers, or I can use the term freight agents. I can use the term freight agents, okay? Because we do have freight agents as well. And then students, another one I can say is management. Management also is very, very critical in this space. So shareholders, freight agents, share. And then students, I can also consider other thing is four are there. Any other things, students, you can comment on practically? That is management.
Government.
Government is coming in the Norland Custom.
The media.
Very good. Media. One more stakeholder. So totally we'll go for 60. 10, 10, 10, 10 marks for each.
Sir, employees.
Employees. I can say yes. I can use the term as freight forwarding staff. Now, students, now, if you observe here, I am being specific to the question. And can I ask one question from Vamsi? In order to develop these points, do I need to have the book knowledge or I should concentrate on the question? What do you think, Vamsi?
Sir, you need to concentrate on the question.
Concentrate on the question. So, students, I want to say one thing. You can study anything you like, but in the exam day, concentrate on the question. Don't even concentrate on my mocks also. Concentrate on the question as much as possible. And the key to passing this exam is how strong you are concentrating. So students, now I can just write down the interest only, because students, did they ask about the power or the interest? Vamsi, power or the interest? Interest, right? Interest, right? There is nothing mentioned about the power of the or interest. Only interest, right? Yes or no? Identify and explain the interest. Now, my question is, students, if you are writing power interest, are you indirectly mugging up? What do you think, Vamsi? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Correct, right? So, students, again, I'm repeating, students, the problem in this exam is if you start mugging up, you will get very less marks, because they know how the students are writing. And be very, very careful when you are thinking, students, it's interest of the key stakeholders. So students, Nolan Custom, I will just write down here. So I will write down here. Nolan is a well-developed economy, right? Yes or no? Developed economy, where the customs are highly regulated, comma, and then students, I will continue, highly regulated, comma. Therefore, the interest on the compliance, 1 minute, someone needs to mute the mic. Students, please mute the mic because your background is affecting. Okay, so therefore, highly regulated, therefore, the interest on the compliance will be very high. In this case, they will be more concerned whether this was a negligence or whether this was a system issue. Suppose if it is a negligence, then they may impose what, students? They may impose fines, and also they may suspend the operations. Full stop. So students, now here, when you are looking at a stakeholder, you need to say why they are interested in. So students, now if you observe here, I am clearly mentioning the why element very, very specific to the current point of view. So students, I will come to the next one, the shareholders. Now, I want to ask a question from Vamsi. Now, shareholders wise, they are highly interested or less interested? What do you think, Vamsi?
They are highly interested in the shareholders.
Highly interested. So I'll write down here. Shareholders. So students, I will be very specific when I'm using this. So shareholders will be highly interested on this issue because the stocks are generally high risk, since the beta factor is 1.25, right, Vamsi?
It's 1.15.
1.15.
beta factor is 1.15. So student shareholders will be highly interested on this issue because the stocks are generally high risk since the beta factor is 1.15. This incidence may make the shares more riskier since the issue has come to the general public, where there is a service reputation risk. Agree, no students, whatever said and done. Therefore, they may request the management for an extraordinary, what students? Can you complete it? Extraordinary? This is what? Extraordinary general meeting. General meeting. Students, extraordinary general meeting will be conducted. So students, before I go into the freight agents, are you clear with the students? They are highly interested. Why they are highly interested? And it is practically this beta factor is one reason as well. And aviation sector students, you need to understand very sensitive business. So just keep in mind, and our initial discussion was runway. So we need to always be careful that we maintain the runways, terminals carefully. So can we come to the freight agent students, yes or no? So I can say, in the airport sector, freight is generally a business to business segment. So what I will do is I will connect it. Shelby, are you aware about DHL?
Sorry?
DHL, companies like DHL, UPS,
yes, DHL.
FedEx.
Yes.
So students, yes. In this type, I prefer. Now, Vamsi, you are asking, right? Can we write this example? Can you remember, Vamsi? I said, no need. You get what I'm saying. Frankly speaking, Vamsi, more simple the answer, more chances you will pass. You get what I'm saying, Vamsi. Keep the answer as simple as possible, like a 10th standard student can understand. Unfortunately, beta factor will be a technical knowledge. So students, see students, answer is a technical blend as well. You see beta 1.15 shows that you have a technical knowledge. You get the point what I'm saying, students. So students, I will now connect with a practical example. In real life, there can be freight agents, such as I can write down DHL, FedEx, and then students, can you remember another party? We have UPS, if I'm not mistaken. Evergreen, right? If I'm not mistaken, Sambamsi, I think the Suez Canal was blocked by, there was a freight company called Evergreen, right? Can someone remember the name of the company, students? The Suez Canal was blocked recently. Jaideep, can you remember the name of the company where the Suez Canal got blocked, the ship?
No, sir.
No, Mr. Amit, can you remember that Suez Canal block, one company? I can't remember the name.
No, I also can't remember, sir.
Anup, can you remember?
It was Evergreen only.
Evergreen, right? Correct, right?
Evergreen. Yeah.
Evergreen. Evergreen. So students, this is very sensitive. You can also connect that, but this is air freight. So we may not have that blocking issue. So Evergreen. So students, I will just continue with the next point. So I can say, therefore, these organizations may be concerned of how the airport deals with their consignments, Further, there can be chances for legal litigations, agree or not agree students, yes or no, there can be high chances of legal litigations as well. So students, I'll come to the management. So I always appreciate the answer of Ms. Aju, because Aju was the only person in our class understood this properly, that our management is not a centralized management. Our management is decentralized management. And at the moment, from this issue, now I'll be very, very honest, in the exams, the paper will be like this, very vague. You need to make your own assumption, like what Aju did. Now, Vamsi, can I ask you a question?
Sir.
How many airports do we have in total?
Six.
Six. Do you think in all six airports or in Nolan? In Nolan, we have four. But do you think in all the four airports, do you think this system issue would happen or one airport? What do you think, Vamsi?
One airport.
One airport, right? Students, that one airport only. So I'll speak to Shailvi. Shailvi, are you clear with that judgment of one airport?
Yes, sir. Understood.
No, this is maturity, students. This is maturity. So I think Anoop and Mr. Amit will get this point of view, because y'all may be involving with a lot of similar conversation where they will just say this only. They won't go in detail, and they'll say, using your experience, you will do the detail analysis. Correct, Mr. Amit?
Right. Correct.
Correct, right? So Anoop, I think you are getting the point, right, Mr. Anoop, if I'm not mistaken?
True. Yes.
True. So students, just remember, you need to little think like a manager only. So just use it. So appreciate Aju. Aju, can we have a small discussion if possible?
Yes, sure, sir.
Aju, in the exam condition, how you were able to think so?
I will think in a real life scenario. I think that I am a senior manager there, and if such incident occurs, what I will be doing?
Excellent. And I think I spoke to someone in our class. I think I spoke to Shailvi. Shailvi, can you remember? I told you the case study should be absorbed. Can you remember,
right,
Shailvi?
And
Shailvi, if not memorize, memorizing is different, absorbing is different. So if you absorb, you feel like you are a manager there. You get what I'm saying, Shailvi?
So yes, if you get
that feeling only, you can tackle the situation practically. So I'll write down here. At present, so this is the critical point. At present, the airports are decentralized. That you need to remember, that students. And if this answer was mentioned, if this point was mentioned on the exam day, if you had mentioned this, I'm telling students, definitely passed. You would have passed the paper. I'll be very critical and honest here. You would have easily cleared the paper. So at present, the airports are decentralized. Therefore, the senior management, that is board of directors, I'll write down within brackets, board of directors, the group I can say, will be more concerned on the particular airport with this issue. They will be interested to have an internal audit. Students, can you remember I told you P3 paper, how many percent is audit, students? I think it's 25% internal control system. Will be interested to have an internal audit. Find out the reason why there is a system failure. Why there is a system failure. And bring the airport managers for an accountability review. And then they will be, I can specifically say, they will be asked to modify the existing system. Full stop. So students, I think this gives you a very clear picture on the interest point of view. So I'll come to the media as well. So if you observe here, media is again one of the interested person. Can I say why it is an interested person is, Vamsi, can you tell me why media is interested? What is the benefit for them?
Yes, sir, the TRP.
No. Please don't go in the Indian aspect because this is UK. They have media ethics. In UK, media ethics is strong. Anup?
No.
I'll come here. So I'll write down here. The media will be more concerned since aviation is an essential what service for an economy. Agree, students? Yes or no? Aviation is essential service for an economy. Further, it is the responsibility of the general public to understand the importance of any failure in the system. So I'll continue. The increase in the metal may cause pollution to the environment. That you need to understand, students. Therefore, the media will be much concerned. Will be much concerned. Very, very important. Much concerned. Medical industry, very highly media will be interested. So can we come to the freight forwarding staff? That means our company staffs who have been working. So students, now if you observe, I can say the freight forwarding staffs in the airport will be highly interested to understand their mistakes. Therefore, in future, if there is any similar issues, they will be able to whistle blow. What is that, students? They will be able to what, students? A whistle blow. Are you clear with the students? Yes or no? So students, this is how the structurization should be. And can I ask you one question? Once, whistleblow is a technical language or it's a practical word? Whistleblow. It's a technical language, right, students? Internal audit is a technical language. So students, here, this is like a working environment, where you will be communicating like a finance manager using a little bit of technical blending. Are you clear with that, student? So this is the part A requirement what we have done. So just, I will... Yes, please.
Just one thing. I think the freight forwarding staff, won't they be... just like a manual sort of a backup to the systems, or, you know, rather they would actually be using the system, because I think that would be an automated sort
semi-automated.
Of a system.
Semi-automated. That's what they need to understand, what okay. is the weakness, because if they don't know the know-how, they you can't blame them as well, because if you generally observe most of the inefficiencies takes place because people don't know the know-how or know-why. They just know the operation management only. That is the main reason many people are having an issue. Are you understanding what I'm saying there?
No, I got your point. What I was actually thinking was that, you know, if this has been, say, hacked, so I think
they need not, they will not, they'll only know the sound, click, click, that okay, noise, they will, right, you get right. What I'm saying. So they don't know outside the box thinking.
Got it.
It's better to make them think outside the box so that in case of emergency, they will react and tell to the management.
Got it,
right? So I'll tell one more thing. I'll just tell one more thing as well. Now, during the pandemic situation, do you think which employee is mostly valuable for a company? Vamsi?
The workers?
No, not the workers. I can say the security in the front office. Because Mr. Amit, if the security in the front office has not been properly communicated with the COVID, and he just lets inside people without any proper controls, that's a weakness of the company, right, Mr. Amit? What do you think?
Absolutely,
right. So students, frankly speaking, like in the universities, the securities have been trained like a medical officers. But if I go to a mall, the securities are just doing this for the sake of doing. I can observe the differences. You get what I'm saying, students? Because even you would have observed in some bigger places, they are not even bothered that you are washing the hands also. What do you think, students? Yes or no? And when you go to some places, they are very, very strict in washing the hands. And then only they will take you inside. You can observe what I'm talking about. Practically, you can feel that. So students, just remember what I'm saying is, in practical world, one weakness is the operational level staffs are just taught to do a stuff. You do this, you do this, you do this. But they don't know why they are doing that. But if they understand the reason, then they will know when to whistleblow. That's the point. So thank you for that point. So students, can we go to the second one? Evaluation of the collective risk management by the board, that is the 40%. So can we go through that, students? Yes or no? Yes, we can go through that. So students, now my question is, evaluate the CEO's proposal on the executive director should take collectively own and manage the risk. Now, one problem we have is our company is centralized or decentralized. What do you think, students? Our company is decentralized, right? And even if the executive directors take collective responsibility, I still say it will end up as a failure, because I can say the airport managers in charge should also be a part of this. And if they are also in the part of this, then only the operational level staff will be directed. So only executive directors taking and managing risk will definitely end up as a failure. And I can say CEO should extend his vision also to the management level. And we say as the risk culture and the risk appetite should expand in this organization, so that in future, in case of any emergency, the reaction will be faster. Are you clear what I'm saying, students? Yes or no? Vamsi, is that clear or not clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
So I told you the critical point in this paper. I told you if you are able to write the airports are decentralized, you will pass. Now, students who fail in the 70s, who Vamsi, I think it's for you and me discussion. And Akansha also can listen for the discussion. Vamsi and Akansha and even Aju, if you observe, if your failing rate is on 70s, I feel you are a very good student, but in the exam day, you are missing one critical point. Aju, do you agree or not agree, Aju? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, right. Vamsi, what do you think, Vamsi? You would have missed one critical point like this.
Yes, sir.
Agree, right? So students, can you just remember these students? This is a very, very essential. And even Anoop, are you there, Anoop? By any chance, can you just observe what we were discussing here? The yes. critical point is this. So more and more you study short notes, more and more you go through past papers. I don't say not to do. I say it's okay. But don't make it as a habit and forget the main story in the examination. So just remember these students, it's very, very, very important for you all to keep the understanding here. Because if you miss the point, you will find it very, very, very difficult. Jaydeep, by any chance, are you there? Jaydeep?
Yes, sir.
Jaydeep, last time when you did the management case study, you was thinking very sharp to the point. So I want you to come to that standard. You get what I'm saying, Jaydeep? Because
yes.
in your answer, this decentralization was missing. I think everyone should maintain a journal and write it down, that mistake, the decentralization, because you are a senior finance manager and you should act practically in this situation. Shelvi, are you now clear with the question?
Right, sir. Yes, I am.
Clear, no? So just remember that. That's how you give the blind spot. So I will just come to this point. I can say a listed company. So students, I'll just make it very simple so that I'll be to the point. A listed company should have a risk committee. Should have what, students? A risk committee. And I can say our field is having. Agree, yes or no, students? Our field is having a risk committee. So students, can we just check who is the head of the risk committee? By any chance, did they mention the heads of the risk committee? Vamsi, did they mention the heads? Who is heading the committee? So they just gave the members in there.
They just gave the members.
Members, right? So students, that can be a point of view that you can write it in the exam, students, because if you observe this table, the risk committee, we have the chairman as usual, and then Martin Harris is there, and then Hesham El Said is also there. So Hesham is an entrepreneur guy. And if you see, our CEO is also coming from a different background. And Martin Harris, just a minute, Martin Harris is a banker. So he may have little understanding as well. So if you observe here, students, the risk committee is given without the head. So that is a one point of view we need to consider. So what I will consider here, let's come back to the application, students. What I will consider here is, let's start working. It's having, our field is having. But we need to make it clear. We need to make it clear to the shareholders of who is heading the risk committee. Who is heading the risk committee? Because students, that is very essential. So now I will continue here. The CEO is correct. I'm talking to him. The CEO is correct. However, look at the way I am making the CEO feel like he is wrong, but I'm not deliberately saying he's wrong. CEO is correct. However, it will be better. Look at the way I am connecting. It will be better if the business model can be taken into consideration. Can be taken into what, students? Consideration. At present, we have decentralized the airport operations. Decentralized the airport operations, where every airport has its own management. Every airport has its what, students? Own management. So that is very specific and very clear for you. So we can understand the senior managers taking the risk, the senior board members taking the risk collectively will not increase the efficiency. What do you think, students? Because the why I'm saying it will not improve the efficiency, only one reason I can specifically say, students, it will not improve the efficiency because of one reason. What is that one reason, students? Just remember, that is our company is decentralized. And Mr. Chaudhary, stop writing in the screen. It's distracting me. Sorry, students.
Sir, I have just one or two points, if I may.
Yes, Mr. Amit.
Sir, now, I mean, if you're saying that, you know, this is a decentralized company, which is fine, which is, I think, what they had also mentioned. But, you know, when you look at the facts, is that they do not have a risk committee. They do not have cyber security.
Risk committee all are there. Risk committee,
okay, audit committee, I'm sorry, I'm sorry,
nomination is already there.
No.
Fine, right, Mr. Amit.
Yeah, because it's already there.
But the issue here, Amit, is if you observe, our business model is decentralized. Because frankly speaking, airports cannot be centralized, as per my knowledge. Because I'll be very honest with you, a small country like Sri Lanka itself is having a diversity. Because Sri Lanka is smaller than Tamil Nadu also. Okay, what happens is, Anit, Jaffna Airport is completely different. You will get a complete different exposure. And the Colombo Airport is completely different. And I can say the Batticlo Airport is also completely different management. And why there is completely different management is the regional visitors are completely different. Jaffna will be mostly visited by Canadians, generally. And if you see the Colombo Airport will be visited by the Australians, and the Batticlo Airport will be coming from the Chinese. So if you observe, those three segments are completely cannot be centralized. Are you clear, Mr. Amit?
No, I'm clear, sir. But just one point is that, when you look at the risks, what they had, which were there, I think the cybersecurity risk was not mentioned there.
No, risk register wise, no. I can agree with you. Cybersecurity was not mentioned. Resilience is mentioned, and then environment is mentioned, and health and safety is mentioned. And even if you see in the business resilience, they have only focused on the major operational risk, like the weather, runway, fueling risk, everything. So you are correct here. I don't say you are wrong here. You are correct here. But the only thing is, now they have learned. If you observe this question, what happens is, Amit, if you see practically, they will test you something which is not there in the precinct. So you are correct. Okay. So we don't have cybersecurity as a main risk in our risk register.
Right. So I think that is.
But the problem is the CEO is telling that management, the top guys should only take the responsibility. But my question here is, Mr. Amit, if the top guys take the responsibility in a decentralized center, I think it won't be effective. So the CEO needs to expand his view. Are you clear what I'm saying, Mr. Amit?
Sir, I'm clear, but I still have a very small doubt. This sort of a risk is not there for the full company as a whole, don't you think that, these things should have been there in place? And I think, it is the role.
I can agree with you, but I will be very frank. In reality, you are correct. But I will be very honest here, Amit. But the thing is, in practical, we may get risk what we did not anticipate as well, right? Example like pandemic risk. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So pandemic all we did not anticipate. But now what we may do is, we may account all those things into what I can specifically say. We will account all those things specifically into, I can just write down, as a risk. You get what I'm saying? So that is the situation here. Clear with that, Mr. Amit?
Yes, sir.
It has been mentioned in this pre-scene that when the managers are not able to manage some risk or some big decisions are to be taken, the board of directors do
that is financing and investment decision, not the internal control.
Okay,
sir. Okay, so students, listen carefully. So we can understand that the senior board members taking risk collectively will not increase efficiency. So I will write down in the next paragraph as a solution, because students, again, remember this carefully: decentralized. In decentralized operations, senior management decision will never be successful unless they educate it. Mr. Amit, can I give you a very classic example?
Yes, sir.
Swachh Bharat is success or not success?
Swachh Bharat is success in some parts.
Some parts, right?
Yes.
Because that some parts would have got the understanding properly. What do you think, Mr. Amit? Yes or no? correct, right? But
no, sir, I got your point. But
you got the point, right? Because the thing is, Swachh Bharat will be only successful if they decentralize it. You get what I'm saying?
I got your point, but. So the this scheme was there from the center, right? But
correct.
My point is that if something is not there for the full company as a whole, then how can we blame the
no. That's the thing. Now they are going to develop. You get what I'm saying?
Okay.
CEO is not blaming. CEO is telling in future we should do it. You get what I'm saying? We are forward looking. Yes. Okay. Now risk is accepted. We have accepted it. We can't change it. Agree, no, Mr. Amit? So we need to accept that this is our fault. But in future, can we do the same thing once again? No, right? So that will be... And now it's a reputation risk. But again, if happens, it will be more than this. So that's the point, students. So just remember, in decentralization environment, it's very difficult to manage it. So I'll just continue this point. So I can say... Therefore, the senior managers of each airport should be asked to present their view of this risk taking place. And they should also take the accountability to prevent such risk. And further, I'll continue, students, further we need to understand that the operational level is also responsible for a successful business operation. For a successful business operation, since the risk culture should prevail throughout the organization. Listen carefully, students, should prevail throughout the organization. It should not be one place, throughout the organization. Just remember that point, students. It should go throughout the organization where they may able to successfully implement risk management policies. So students, this is the viewpoint. And one thing, students, I may do it in today's class also. Now, students, it's the final CMA exam. So I'm always telling you, just to attract the examiner, you should always, wherever possible, connect the CMA code of ethics. So CMA code of ethics has clearly mentioned there needs to be professional competence and what, students? Competence and due care. So this strategy development, so I can say this risk strategy development will definitely improve, the professional due care. In, I can use the term company. What is our company? AFIL. Because very, very important students, airline industry, human lives are there. So professional due competence and due care is very, very essential. So students, this is the summarized way of presenting. And again, I'm telling you students, it's not the quantity. It is always the point what you are writing. So just remember students who score more than 100 or very good results are writing less with points, insights, I can say. So this is how you need to consider. So before I move into the next point of view, any questions you have, you can ask me, students. If it is fine for you, students, you can put Y in the chat box.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, since our company is a listed company, can we write the share market as the stakeholder?
Yes, I think we have written about that in our investors, if I'm not mistaken.
So one point to add on, sir. This is a bizarre situation which happened for our company. The share price might fall. So because of that, the cost of equity increases. And in that situation, the organization needs to invest in much better portfolio investments. Can we write this, sir?
Of course, more than investments, I can say they can invest in better systems. You get what I'm saying, Pamsi?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
So that's a good point. So students, just remember the risk culture here, because if you observe this is also a very much practical way of writing. And you just observe students, I'll be very honest with you, ethics and risk is very critical to pass this exam. I can say the cake is ethics and risk, and the icing will be the F3 and the P3. So just E3. So students, this is essential. So before I go into this, students, I just want to give you one concern. So it's very important. Students, examination tip. I'll write down here exam tip. So you can start now itself. So students, examination tip, what I can specially consider here is, if you observe students in the exam tip, what I can specially say is journaling. What is that, students? Journaling. So Vamsi, I just want to tell you, please have a small book with you and journal it. And even I'm telling to Shailvi, journaling is important. Because students, in my experience, I always get two categories of students who fail all the mocks, whatever I give, and pass the exam. I need to tell you the truth. And then there is another category of the students who pass all the mocks and fail the exam. Okay, so these are the two possibilities that is there. So the worst case scenario I'm talking here. So the secret of this, why happens, is journaling. Now, I asked the students who failed all the exams and passed the mock final paper. They are telling me whenever they fail the exams, they write down the points why they failed. And one night before the examination, they go through all the mistakes what they did in the class and promise themselves they won't repeat it in the exams. And similarly, students, those who pass the mocks and fail the exam, they said they forget to do the journaling. So in the exam day, they just went assuming they may pass easily, but they failed. So students, please do the journaling from today onwards. Very, very important. One page summary is enough for a day, students. That is one request. So if the examination tip is fine for you, students, can you just put Y in the chat box, students? Thank you very much, students. This is essential, students. This is essential, especially for working professionals. So students, I want to write down a small heading just to guide you. Types of ethics. So students, if you don't mind, can we start doing a small area, students, on the knowledge, types of ethics. So students, I will be directly teaching you all. So there are three types of ethics. One is known as students personal ethics. One is known as what students? Personal ethics. The second one is known as professional ethics. Second one is known as what students? Professional ethics. Professional ethics. And the final one is only known as the business ethics. So students, don't confuse all these together, because in the exams, they may give three ethical situation and you need to observe what is correct, what is wrong. Now, Vamsi, I will come to a question. Now, if you observe, you are a lawyer. Let's assume you are a lawyer. Okay, Vamsi? And you don't like to tell lies. You don't prefer telling lies. Okay? Don't prefer telling lies. So I'll ask you a question. Is that a personal ethics? Yes or no, Vamsi? Agree or not agree? Now, example, Vamsi, you don't like to work in an alcohol company. You don't like to work in alcohol company. You get what I'm saying? So is that a personal ethics? Yes or no? You don't like it. You get what I'm saying, Vamsi? Because do you think people are still working in alcohol, tobacco business? Of course they are working. But my question here is, if you don't like to work in alcohol business, that is your personal ethics. Students, are you clear with what is personal ethics? Yes or no? Now, alcohol business is a legal business. But if you don't like to work in alcohol, that's your personal ethics. So is that fine, students? Yes or no? If you are fine with the personal ethics, can you please put Y in the chat box, students? Personal ethics is individuals, because they may give that in the exam, students. I will connect it to you and make it very clear, because ethics is a sure area, but practical ethics, not mugging up students. Okay. So I'll come to the professional ethics. Now, can I ask you, SIMA code of ethics is what? Vamsi, SIMA code of ethics is what? It is professional ethics, right? What do you think, Vamsi? Yes or no? Because SIMA guys only have this code. As a professional accountant, we have integrity, we have confidentiality, professional due care. After that, I can say professionalism, confidentiality, all these things we are having, okay? Objectivity. All. So this is a professional ethics. And can I ask you one question? Does the pilots need to have professional ethics? What do you think? Yes or no? Because can the pilots travel, take off the airports in a condition where they are not able to concentrate? What do you think, Vamsi? So do they need to have professional ethics? Agree or not?
Yes, sir. Agree.
Yes, right. And can I ask you one thing? Airport staffs, do they need to have a professional ethics? What do you think, Vamsi? Yes or no? Airport staffs, do they need to have? Yes, right. So students, just remember, professional ethics is very much strict in our business segment, especially our airline segment. So can I come to the business ethics, Vamsi? Yes or no? Business ethics. Now, CSR is compulsory or optional?
Optional.
So can I say if a company is doing CSR, it's their personal business ethics. Agree or not agree? Yes or no? Now, can I ask you, Tata is having a lot of business ethics. Do you agree or not agree with me, Vamsi? Yes or no? Agree, right? And then if I ask you a basic Chinese company, a Chinese company, do you think, do they have business ethics, or they just only want to increase their production, whether the environment is polluted or not polluted? You get the difference. If you see, compare Tata with a Chinese company, I can openly say that Tata has high business values compared with a Chinese company. Agree or not agree? Yes or no?
Agree.
So can I ask you one thing? Our field, especially in the airline segment, airport segment, do they need to have at least a basic business ethics? Yes or no? Agree or not agree?
Agree.
Yes or no? Now, can I come into a question now, Vamsi? Now, if you observe, this system failure falls under what ethics?
Business ethics.
Excellent. Correct. Business ethics. Wonderful. I think my delivery has been perfect. So students, this is a business ethics, because this was not a negligence of any individual, because it's a duty of this business. Like all were selling cybersecurity, now it's a business ethics. Can you remember that data? Can you remember data extraction from the boarding pass? what ethics is that, Vamsi? Data extraction.
I think that is
business, right? Again, business, right?
Business, yes, ethics, yes.
Purely business, right? Because students, Facebook. Can I say Facebook is having lack of business ethics? What do you think, Vamsi? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
They are going too much into individuals' privacy. So students, is that becoming very clear for you, students? So if the accountant personally makes a mistake, then that's a professional ethics, one individual who is employed. And let's assume you personally don't like something, that is personal ethics. So I'll be very frank, students, in the exams, you should be able to differentiate between professional ethics and what, students? Business ethics. So students, if this is clear for you, I think that will be a greater understanding for you, students. So if you can differentiate between professional ethics and business ethics, I believe the presence of mind is important, then you can easily pass the exams. So any questions here, students, on professional, business and personal ethics, you can ask me. If it is clear for you, students, can you please put Y in the chat box, students? Thank you very much, students. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, so now, students, now I think this section is over. So I want to do a special section with you. Now, Vamsi, can you remember, Vamsi, we were learning about the co-activities? Yes or no, Vamsi? Can you remember? So Vamsi, this is one of the reasons why the students pass the exam. Because Vamsi, I do give notes. I'm not saying I don't give notes. I do give notes. But you need to understand, this is not a mugging up exam. What do you think, Vamsi? Yes or no? Agree or yes. Not? It's a point of view. That means if you observe the Aju answer and Vamsi answer, both got good results, but answers are not same. Completely different. And students, that is the success of a teacher here. How much differentiation your students can perceive rather than standardization. So Vamsi, now if you observe this co-activity decoding we did, right? If I'm not mistaken, can you remember, Vamsi?
Yes,
so students, I'm giving you a special exercise. So what I want to do is, now what I will do is, you already know this, correct? No, students, so just a minute. So students, today I'll write down here, I will send this down in our portal as well. Co-activity brainstorming. What is that, Vamsi? Proactivity brainstorming. So students, now this is the best way to study, because self-study is the most productive study. But here as a teacher, I will be with you, but I won't spoon feed you, because this paper is not spoon feeding. So now, and roles and responsibility of leaders. Agree? No? Yes or no, Vamsi? Do you see roles and responsibility of leaders?
Yes,
agree? So I will write down a verb, evaluate the roles and responsibilities of leaders in which organization? Our field. Are you observing what I'm saying here, Vamsi? Yes or no? So I can say, just for your understanding, leadership, one small sentence of an intro, leadership is the factor for goal congruence of an entity. This is my own word, students, because one beauty of SEMA is no need to memorize, goal congruence for an entity. And then students, I can say, at present, at our field, we have two tier boards. Agree? Yes or no? Where we have an executive board and what? And non-executive board. You understand what I'm saying here? Yes or no? We have committees. So I'll just make it like this. We have independent committees. You get what I'm saying? Independent committees. Are you clear what I'm saying here, Vamsi? Yes or no? Are you understanding?
So students,
can't you, now if you see, I this is not done, I will guide you, not immediately, this is near the exam time, I will guide you, because now I want you to make your mind open. So now, Vamsi, I'll make it very clear. So you see product matrix, right, Ansoff matrix. So what I want to do is, I want you to go through the decoding and write down, evaluate what? Product, market, matrix for which company? Afil, you get what I'm saying, Vamsi? Yes or no? So students, we can just do. We have 6 airports. Agree, no, Vamsi? Yes or no? 6 airports. Okay, at present. So that is the pre-seen material. And then you can do the simulation. Example, we can expand. To Asia, possible or not possible? Yes or no, Vamsi? We can expand to Asia, which will be a market what? A market development. Agree, no, students? Yes or no? A market development. We can increase the terminals in the existing airport. Agree or not agree, Vamsi? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Look at the language I'm using, which is product development. Which is what? Product development. Okay. Are you understanding, students? Which is product development? We can compete with Skyline in the same market with a similar airport. Using what strategy? Using penetration strategy. You get what I'm saying here, Vamsi? Yes or no? However, so look at the way I am competing. Look at the way I am developing. So students, you should come to this standard. However, in a Lion's Pride industry, it may not be feasible. It may not be what? Feasible. Are you fine with that, Vamsi? Yes or no?
Yes,
any questions, Vamsi?
Yes,
so students, can you do this for all? Evaluate generic strategy. Evaluate trend analysis. Can you do it like that, Vamsi? Evaluate cloud computing. Evaluate big data. I will observe your thinking, students. Students, did you understand co-activity brainstorming, what I'm doing? Because when we do this, the entire syllabus is completed. What do you think, Vamsi? Yes or no?
Yes, sir, correct.
And the entire syllabus is completed, plus your thinking is becoming more standardized. Agree or not agree? Yes or no, Vamsi? Because you won't go for mugging up. Now, see here, I said penetration strategy, but I connected that mugging up with the business application. Lion's Pride industry, it's not be feasible. Correct, no? So, students, if you got the activity what I told you, can you just put Y in the chat box, students? So you can do this. And when we are meeting on Friday, you just uploaded this in the portal. You complete this in the portal and upload it. So individually, I will go through, but I won't correct it immediately and do it to you, because I want you to do more research. You get what I'm saying, Vamsi? Because I'll be very frank, students. More and more you study text, more and more you study short notes, more and more you analyze past papers. At the end, how much you are connected to the business matters. So I say, better to follow the co-activities, develop your own way of thinking, and I will correct the way of thinking. And then students, exam day, you will find it very, very confident, I can say. Clear? So students, if it is clear for you, can I get a Y in the chat box? I think everyone has put Y in the chat box.
I have a small request, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, can we submit it by Sunday? Because tomorrow we have office work as well.
Office is there, right? Can you do at least 50%? Or at least a basic writing? half of
this. I'll try it, but in the hurry, hurry, I can't complete it by Friday.
Sure, no problem. But don't give up. You get what I'm saying, Vamsi. You get what I'm saying. I understand what you're saying here. But now are you clear, Vamsi, how to effectively use your time?
Yes, sir. Got it.
It is clear, right? Now, Shailvi, are you clear here with what I was explaining? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes,
so, students, if you don't know cloud computing, then you can use the study text and understand what is cloud computing. And I will also guide you if you have a huge question, everything. So I will definitely guide you in that as well. So Jaydeep, are you clear with what I'm mentioning there? Yes or no, Jaydeep?
Yes, sir.
Super, super. So students, let's meet up on the Friday class. So you don't have any activities other than this co-activity brainstorming. So on Friday, let's meet students. So thank you very much, students, for your kind cooperation. So see you all on Friday, same time, students. Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.